excuse us, just coming out of prayer, it's such a high time of prayer. I'm not trying to rush anything, but it is that time for King finances. We're at 11715 Rainwood Road here in the great city of Little Rock, Arkansas. Remnant Church International pastors, Dr. Victor Wynn and Dr. Robin Wynn, phenomenal, phenomenal, awesome shepherds of God's people. This is Kingdom Finances at 9, and we're coming behind us at 9:30. We have Minister Caleb Brown and his beautiful wife, Sister Paige Brown, coming with Kingdom Marriages. And at 10 a.m., the man of God himself will come forth with a power-packed word. Not going to prolong the time. We're going to go ahead and get started with some prayer, and we're going to dive into this. Father, thank you. Thank you for your soaking and outpouring in this place already. Thank you for how you're speaking to the hearts of your people, encouraging them to continue forward in the things that you have outlined out for us to do. So, Father, we decrease now. We ask that you increase within us to say whatever that we will say whatever you will have us to say and do whatever you will have us to do. We love you, Father, and we always honor you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Once again, good morning. Don't take it lightly. Thank you, Facebook, for tuning in. For those of you who are tuned in, for joining with us this morning. We've been talking the last several weeks about fear of missing out, fear of messing up. And we kind of dwell on fear of messing up a little bit. We went into some different areas with that last week. But one of the main things this week we're going to deal with, and it's kind of ironic, the woman of God was praying. She said a couple of things, what we're going to be talking about today. And we just want to encourage everybody to not wear out in the process. Not being worn out in the process. And some people are going to be like, well, what are you talking about? Well, if you or anywhere on the earth and you're paying attention, there are a lot of things across the airwaves that are just dominating the cycle. And just to be frank and honest, it's a lot of it really is good things to hear about. I mean, it's doom, gloom, death, pandemic. It's almost as if, I mean, if you just went by that, you almost think that the world is on fire and that nothing good is happening. And it is those things that are causing people to be worn out, weary of hearing it, and what is happening. And I'm mainly speaking to the people of God this morning. What is starting to happen, the promises of God are starting to be forgotten about. And how do I know this? Because the language of the people is starting to shift and change to match up with what the circumstances are. And that's very, 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 very dangerous and very, very bad. And let me explain why. Over in Galatians, I want to say chapter 6, it talks about the laws of sowing and reaping. And you got to understand, whatever you release out of your mouth, that which you will harvest, good or bad. Now, we don't like to talk about that and think about it like that, but that is a law that is actively working in the earth, whether we understand it or not. That's why the scripture declares that death and life are in the power of the tongue. But the scripture says death first. Be careful what we are releasing. Because if we correlate what we are releasing with our circumstances, you know, it may be that, man, we're going along with what the doctors and stuff are saying. And I'm not diminishing science. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm mainly talking about is, let me ask this, and on Facebook, you can throw your hands up on this as well. How many people at the sound of my voice did God give a word to? Raise your hand. Now, riddle me this. Is what you are hearing, if you're hearing anything coming across the airways, is it contrary to what God has spoken to you? Is it different? Okay. Now, yeah, I know it's different for me. because it is different, then I know that I cannot allow my language to align up with what that is being said. And that's why we have to be careful, especially in this season, actually every season in life, but really particularly in this season, you know, because it's still, you know, the season of say, you know, the mouth. And we really have to be careful who we are aligning with and who we are allowing in our spaces. Now, we're supposed to be quarantined, but even at the house. Because I don't care who it is, if you're not aligned and speaking with what God has spoken to me, I'm not allowing you to contaminate what God has told me. It's too critical. It is too important. And we've come today just to remind and to encourage the people of God, don't be worn out. And we're going to talk about a couple of things that will keep you in a place of focus not to be worn out. We're going to be dealing with, we have two scriptures, but I think we're just going to be camping out in Isaiah 3 and 10 today. The other scripture that we have is Galatians 6 and 9, but we're going to start here in Isaiah 3 and 10. And powerful word. And I'm going to read it out in the the King James Version. It says, say to the righteous that it shall be well with him, for they shall eat the fruit of their doings. Now that's very, very, very important. Why is that important? Because what has God given you with your hands? We keep going back to some certain things. What are we doing with our hands? Have we started to contaminate what God has spoken to us by negative talk, negative thought, negative belief of what he's given us? Because that scripture says what they are doing. Doing. What are we doing? Are we in doubt? Are we allowing fear to run us in what we're supposed to be doing for God? And I'm going to stop right here in a little bit here and let my wife jump in here. But let me read this out of the New Living Translation. It says, but all will be well for those who are godly. Tell them you will receive a wonderful reward. Now, how many people at the sound of my voice really believe that? Now, we may jump into this, but I don't know. We'll see how this goes. The more we start studying this, the more we start dealing with this, Abraham keeps bubbling up. And faith and obedience keeps bubbling up. And righteousness. Understand something. Well, you know what? Let me start here. We're talking about not being worn out by circumstances and everything. You know, back in September, my wife noticed a leak in our closet that's like next door, right up to our shower. And we was like, man, where's this coming from? And we tried to call so many different people to come fix this thing. And do you know that we could not find anybody? Either folk were too busy, or either folk were just, you know, not available. And I was like, well, man. But we were still able to take a shower because we had another shower. Now, we found somebody to correct the issue. But now, if you go in the closet, the wall is ripped out. And, you know, the pipes and stuff is exposed. Now, I'm getting to a point here. Me and my wife ain't complaining because there's stuff out, the insulation stuff is on the floor. We're not worried about that. Now, like I said, this happened back in September. Here it is now, what, July? 9 months ago. We did not allow that to change our conversation. We ain't worried about that.
Amen. Amen.
What I'm trying to establish is stuff don't happen. But it's your language and your position and your mindset is what's going to carry you through.
Come on. Come on.
The amazing thing about that is that the enemy will cause things to happen to make you look at your blessing as a curse. He will cause things to come up to get you to turn your face, to get us to turn our face and start to speak, oh man, no, you know what we should have bought. If we were renting, this would be our landlord's problem. He would have had to find somebody. And it's just, you know, this whole process of not getting weary, of course, you know, it starts with you. You know, God speaking to us and showing us, hey, don't get tired, don't stop, don't slow down, don't change your confession. Because what happens is, and like the illustration he gave me is, this is an amazing gift. We're thirsty, okay? So this is an amazing gift. This is a beautiful blessing. And we've been waiting for this blessing. And here it is. Here's the blessing. But it's not all of it. It's just a piece of the blessing. But because we're so thirsty and we're so tired of waiting for water, we will think this is it. Thank you, God. I'm gonna take a drink. Thank you. Thanks. So here what happens after a couple of, actually it's water, so after a couple of hours, it's not hot anymore. I mean, cold anymore. Some people like room temperature, so, you know, for those that like room temperature, you know, this does not apply to you. But after a while, it's not enough. And so then what happens? Instead of us saying, you know what, Father, let's refocus, let's redirect. I'm sorry, I got sidetracked and I got so focused on this piece of the wholeness of you, a little piece that I stopped moving. Instead of us doing that, instead of us acknowledging it, we just conform and we try to make this work. We try to make this enough. And it's not. And so when God said, tell the righteous that it shall be well with them, and they shall eat the fruit of their deeds, that was such an encouraging word, because it's a word of going. It's a word of doing. It's a word of action. It is speaking to the actual things that we are doing. And that's what today is the encouragement of. You know, Dr. Wynn is going into talking about covenant, and he's been talking, he's been truly speaking a mighty word of strength and encouragement and of, hey, you know, because having a conversation the other day, there's a lot of words, like my husband said, a lot going around, and the individual just said to me, you know, I hear what's being said, but I know what God said for me and mine. And that's where she stayed. I know what God is saying for me and mine. So that right there shows me that in the midst of a drought, in the midst of the famine, that household is flourishing. It's not just existing. It's thriving. It's flourishing. And I can confidently say that, because when the action and the language match, you have taken, sorry, Father, we, because you know he's speaking so loudly to us, we have taken the power away from the enemy. When we say, nope, wealth and riches are in my house. Nope, my bank accounts are full and overflowing. Nope, all of my bills are paid. I owe no man anything but love. I am the lender of many nations. I borrow from nobody. As a matter of fact, there is overflow in my house after I lend to the nations. Amen. When we constantly speak the word, my children are healthy, they're mighty, they're obedient, they people the desolate villages, they're coming and in they're going, Holy Spirit is with them. When we do that, the enemy has no power. He has no hook, none to hold on to. It's like we've taken, you know, for you fishermen, and I don't, so if I do not say this right, please. For fishermen who put the thing out there and the reel, and the little hook is on the end of the hook. And so instead of having a hook, they've taken the hook off. So, yes, I know, I'm sorry. It's like, so there's nothing for the enemy to hold on to. There's nothing for him to grab hold of and try to cause a mighty, you know, a confusion in the midst of our confession. There's nothing. But we have to stand. And when God was talking about weariness, it was really interesting, because sometimes we'll talk and we're like, okay, guys, let's not get tired. And we think it's in our efforts. But God is talking about our faith. God is talking about, don't get weary in your faith. Don't get weary in me. It's God's faithfulness, not ours. So when we stand in the faithfulness of God, we're strengthened. He says we can do all things through Christ. So it's not us standing in Marta. It's not standing in Chantel. It's not standing in Jason. Sorry, I said Jason because that's what God calls him. You know, he calls him Deacon too, but you know, right? That's his son. It's not him standing in himself. He's standing in Christ.
Amen.
Husband, son, deacon, whatever title we give him, God says blessed. Because he stands on the promises of God, and his confession and his language match his due diligence.
Amen. Amen.
Somebody may ask, what gives you that confidence? Well, I tell you, I'm glad you asked.
Amen. Yes, sir.
This right here, the word.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because when you have a word from God,
amen.
My God,
amen.
When God has spoken to you personally and gave you a promise, know that it will not return unto him void. It's going to accomplish that which he sent it out to be. Now, so somebody may be like, well, all this has been happening. Well, you know what? Yeah, things happen. But you know what? We may have to get here, baby. Let me just want to introduce this. I'm just reminded of Abraham. Before he was Abraham, he's Abram. And Abram was in the land with his father, and they start traveling. But all of a sudden, daddy got stopped somewhere in the land because some things happened. I'm over in Genesis 11, the end of Genesis, end of 11, about to come to Genesis 12. But you know, at the beginning of Genesis 12, guess what God does? God speaks to the man of God himself. He speaks to Abraham and gives him, I need you to go do this. He didn't know where he was going. He didn't know what he was going to be doing. He just had a word. All you need to do is remind yourself of the word that God has given you and start rehearsing that thing. Because when you rehearsing that thing, it gets you in a place of joy. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. So when you start rehearsing that stuff, you don't got time to be weary. Because as my wife was just saying, we don't see it all. But we know it's bigger than what we are, I mean, where we are right now. But see, if you don't keep that in your mind, you're going to fall off and fall casualty to the things that are taking a lot of people out.
Yeah. And if I could say something, he didn't just tell him. He took him and he showed him. So when we look at that scripture, own it. What is he saying to you? What is he saying to us? What did he show us? He didn't just say, lender of many nations. He showed us. And how did he show us? Hey, Marta, there's a nation right there that needs. Bless them. There's a nation over here that needs. Remember, we're all a nation. We are all so blessed to be blessings. But we have to remember that when God speaks it, he also shows us. Think about it. How you know you've seen yourself there. You know you've seen yourself just straight walking in just great abundance.
Amen.
And if you haven't, I know I have. Okay? I know that I have. You can't tell me nothing.
Come on.
We've seen it. He didn't just speak it to Abraham. He showed it to Abraham. What was then is still now. He is still the God that shows, and he is still the God that speaks, and his word is still alive. Our finances are not under the curse. They're under the blessing. But it truly is up to us to place them in the right place. It's up to us to make sure that we are, you know, the faucet of blessing is where we're sitting and where we're receiving from. Because we can sit there and receive from the fountain of the curse. And that's the world. Looking to the world for instructions and directions instead of going to the Father, which is the fountain of life, the living water, the well that never runs dry.
You know, man, time is running out. And you know, there's just so much stuff that God is really showing right now. But you know, let's do something tangible. Let's do something tangible. Everybody take out a sheet of paper. Take out a sheet of paper. And this is what I want you to write on this sheet of paper. And I want you to post this somewhere throughout your house. Wherever you are, I just want you to post this thing. I want you to write out every word that God is giving you. If you already have it written out, fine. But what I want you to do, I want you to take that. And I want you to rehearse in your mind. Go down the line. Go down the line. And I want you to celebrate or mark every victory that you have experienced along that way.
Every word that did not return to him void, that actually was came into fruition.
Yeah, I want you to do that. Now what I want you to also do, now on that side is going to be God's wins and my losses. Now we're talking about God's word. Follow me. Now it should be 50 to nothing. It took Abram 10 years to see the manifestation of Isaac.
Hallelujah. Come on.
10 years.
Come on.
Even when he tried to manufacture,
he still made his mistake prosper.
He went back and reminded himself, what did God say?
Amen.
So we talk about fear messing up. Look, get up.
Come on.
Don't stay there. Those are tricks designed to wear you out. Also write up there Daniel 7:25 to remind yourself what the enemy is trying to do. See, we have to keep playing these things back. We're creatures of habit. But the more we play this stuff back and the more we start rehearsing this stuff, the more we'll be able to walk free, bold, and in confidence, knowing that God is on my side and I shall see. I shall see the goodness, the fruit of my hands in due season. You know, Galatians 6:9 says, do not be weary in well doing, for in due season you shall reap. If you what?
And we have to remember that the word of God does not return to him void, but it does accomplish what it was sent out to do. Therefore, like he just said, it doesn't matter if it's a word from 10 years ago, if it's a word from 15 years ago, it's not exhausted. Write that word down too. Put that before you. Because that has to come to pass. It doesn't matter what we look like right now when we look ourselves in the mirror, when we first looked and God gave us that word and I didn't have this wrinkle. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if I walked a little faster when he gave me that word and now I'm like, oh Lord, if I fall, God help me. It doesn't matter. The word of God is still true for us. Whatever it was, that's why keeping it, and I know this is finances and people may be looking for something different, but get an understanding that just like in Psalms 128:2, we shall eat the fruit of the labor of our hands. We shall do that. We shall be blessed. And it shall be well with us. We have to believe it.
Amen.
We have to believe it. And the way that we keep our faith fueled, that's like running out of gas. There's no reason for us to run out of gas. All these gas stations, stop and get some gas. If you need gas, stop. Get in the word. Get your gas.
Amen.
You see what I'm saying?
Amen.
There's no reason for our faith fuel to go low when we have a word, we have a vision, and we have God's constant reminder.
Come on. Hallelujah.
You know, we're going to have to end this here. You know, we'll pick this up next week. But you know what we're talking about? And the man of God said to Wednesday, read your covenant. All we're talking about is what God has already given us. It's this covenant.
Yeah. And let me say this. Let me say it this way. If a lawyer came right now and said, hey, you have a relative that just passed, and there's a great estate entitled to you, and here's the paperwork. Okay, now don't lie on that. Don't lie now. How many of y'all would read that from the front to the back twice? I'm just saying, you just received a great inheritance. They didn't tell you what you're getting. They said you received a great inheritance. How many? Front, back, baby, read this. Make sure that I saw this right. Well, that's what God said. Here, our great inheritance.
Come on.
It's here. So when Dr. Wynn talks about the covenant, I'm going to boldly say this. It shouldn't be new to us.
Amen. Oh, yeah.
It should not be new. Him saying, this is the covenant. It should be us saying, thank you, God, for the reminder. Thank you, God, for stretching again. Because we studied ourselves.
Oh, Lord, we're out of time. Look, confess this over yourselves. Say, I shall see,
I shall see
the fruit of my hands.
The fruit of my hands.
Because God says so.
Because God says so.
God bless you. We'll pick this up next week. Coming up at 9:30, we have Minister Taylor Brown and his sister Paige Brown coming with Kingdom Marriages. And at 10 o'clock, the man of God himself will come forward with a power-packed word. We will see you next week. God bless you.